Welcome to Guitar Technique, Episode 8, covering the use of harmonics performed as natural and as the tap-touch style. Now, while the application of harmonics in general isn't exactly a daily technique that's performed by every single guitarist out there, it still is one of those guitar techniques that will occur every now and again, meaning that if you have never done some practice on this technique, now is probably a good time to start learning more about how it operates. Performing natural harmonics is a fairly easy thing to learn, but moving on to performing the touch and the tap style harmonics can be a little more challenging. But you know, with some practice, I'm positive that you'll learn how to begin applying them in your playing. So let's get things started on this lesson covering the interesting sounds of applying harmonics on the guitar. In exercise one, we're going to just introduce the concept of naturally occurring harmonics. Now, on the guitar, we get natural harmonics occurring at the 5th fret, at the 7th fret, and also up at the 12th fret. So these three locations provide us with natural harmonics that are nice and bright and easy to attain. Usually on an electric guitar, what you want to do is flick your pickup selector switch so that you're dealing with the bridge position pickup. That's the pickup that's furthest back on the guitar's body. So when we set the pickup to that setting and we just float our finger right over top of, let's say, the 5th fret wire, and you can see I've just got it right over the wire. I'm not actually in the fret zone, you know, I'm not in the fret region. I'm actually over the wire itself. And if you just very lightly touch over top of that wire, you get that bell chime harp effect. And the same thing will hold true if you move up to 7th fret. And then again, the same thing will hold true if you go all the way up to 12th fret. And now remember though too that the fret wire is going to be the fret wire ahead. So it's the one closer to the guitar's body, not the fret wire that's closer to the headstock. It's the one closer to the guitar's body. And all you need to do is test and operate this a little bit so that you start developing the technical attribute for going across the chord and getting that bell chime effect. I should say across the strings, not really. I mean, it's creating a chord, but in that case there, you know, for instance, going across the 5th fret, I've got the notes of D, G, and B. So right there is a G chord. If I go over here to the 7th fret layout, I've got basically a D major chord. And then if I'm up at the 12th fret here, again, I've got a G major chord once again. So really the 5th fret layout, where I have those notes of D, G, B up at that higher octave, that's the same notes, D, G, B, as when I go up to the 12th fret. So the 5th fret layout of tones for that G chord is the same thing as the 12th fret, except we're an octave lower. Now, when we deal with the 7th fret, however, it's a little bit different. We're getting sort of like an interval off that, where we're dealing with an A and a D and an F sharp, creating a D major sound. Can hear the correlation, right? So some interesting effects that we can generate. These, you know, they really are chords, but it's totally different effect. It sounds like kind of a bell chime effect or a harp effect. And these harmonics, they occur naturally, very easy to play at 5th, 7th, and 12th. Now, I'm using a clean guitar channel sound right now, but if I were to add overdrive or distortion, especially a really thick, crunchy distortion, I would be able to get harmonics out of different locations of the neck as well. You know, I'd be able to go to other places like the 3rd fret, and even though I can't really get them here on a clean channel sound right now, I would be able to do that if I had distortion. You can get the overtones much easier with all that crunch and overdrive. So keep that in mind too, because you'll often hear, you know, especially guitar players like Joe Satriani or Steve Vai, they'll tap into other harmonics that are located in other spots, but you do pretty much have to have overdrive and distortion on the guitar to be able to generate those particular ones. So in example 1A of the handout, I've already given these 5th and 7th position and 12th position harmonics, the natural harmonics. And I've, you know, focused on the string sets that are the most popular, so the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. But, you know, this doesn't go without saying that, you know, you still have them located on 5th and 6th and You know, if you want to get the one on the first string, it's there as well. So just keep that in mind. It doesn't all only occur on the fourth and third and second strings, as I've shown in the handout. You can do this across any one of the strings in fifth region, seventh, or in 12th. So keep that in mind. There's some really interesting sounds that you can generate. These are all displayed for you in example 1A of the handout. I'm going to take a short break and come back in just a moment, and I'm going to play a riff for you that I put together. It's in your handout under example 1B, and it's just going to use some of those seventh position natural harmonics within a riff. So we'll check that out right away. That's an excerpt from the eighth lesson of my guitar technique course. The remainder of this lesson is available behind a paywall on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. But I thought you'd like to see this segment, so I put it here on YouTube for you to get a good idea about what the guitar technique course has to offer. If you want to subscribe to my website and gain access to this course along with my introductory, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs, plus many other guitar courses on the website, just head over to creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership to get started. Then later you can always upgrade into either a monthly, or you could even do the discounted yearly membership plan. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me by phone or email. Just click on the link in the YouTube description box under where it says become a member today. If you're interested in learning faster, making better use of your time, and practicing longer, the Accelerating Your Learning Curve ebook is for you. There's over 60 pages of information on how to take control of both the way you learn and the time that you devote to your practicing. Accelerating Your Learning Curve is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Thanks for watching part one of the lesson. Be sure to sign up for a membership at creativeguitarstudio.com to watch the rest. We'll study the melodic application of harmonics, the tap-touch approach, and how intervals work with this technique. Plus, as a member, you'll also be able to download the handout for this lesson along with many more professional guitar lessons. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch up next in the members area.